Among there was a fear for the mystery, an outrider that loved the venery, a manly man to ben an abed able. Full many a dainty horse had he in stable, and when he rode, men milt his brindle hair, ging glennen a whistling a wind als clear, and ache as lewd as doth the chapel bell, there as this lord was keeper of the cell. The rule of Saint Mar or of Saint Benet, because that it was old and some nil strained, this ilke monk laid all the things pass, and held after the new world the spas. He have not of that text a bullet hen, that saith that hunters been not holy men, ne that the monk, when he is rich less, is lignet till a fish that is waterless. This is to say, a monk out of his cloister. But till the text held he not worth an oyster, and he said his opinion was good. What shall his study and mark himself in wood, upon a book and cloister all way to poor, or swinking with his hands and labour, as Austin did, who shall the world be serving? Let Austin have his swing to him reserving. Therefore he was a precursor a richt, grey hundes he had as swift as fool in fleet. Of pricking and of hunting for the hare was all his lust for no cost wall this bar. He seek his slave as perfield at the hand, with grease and that the finest of a land. And far to fasten his hood under his chin, he had of goldy rock the full curious pin. A loof not in the greater end there was. His head was bald that shone as any glass, and ache as fast as he had been in mind. He was a lord full fat and in good point, his e'en stem and rolling in his hand, that stemmed as a furnace of a lane, his boat assumed his horse in greatest stand. No certainly he was a fair prelad, he was not pale as a forpined ghost. A fat swan loved he best of any rost. His palfrey was as brown as is a berry.